morning.
Morning.
You'll never make a carpet, Mr. Fletcher. Why don't you get one of the girls to do that?
Well, as a matter of fact, it's not entirely Wentworth business.
It's private, you mean?
Well, semi-private. I'm applying for a job.
They're not leaving us.
I mightn't get the job.
Oh, well, it's not outside the prison service.
No, as a matter of fact, I'm applying for the governorship of Barnhurst.
Kay White, you know the rules of the bar, don't you?
I know it's my only chance to get any cigarettes.
Right, then. That's it, ladies. Now, don't forget to fill out your forms before you go back to work.
Oh, fill that in. After all, we might not like the same brand of fags.
Come in, dear. You must be Kevin Burns.
Yes, that's right.
Yes, well, sit down. I sorry to drag you away from work, but I couldn't speak to you on the telephone.
Yeah, well, look, is Doreen okay? She hasn't been injured or anything.
No, she's not injured.
Well, she's not sick.
Sit down, have a nice cup of
tea. No, look, I'm sorry, I didn't come here for a cup of tea. I came here because you said it was about Doreen and it was urgent.
Well, it is urgent. I want you to give your wife a good talking to. You know, the silly girl wants to have an abortion. It seems I've dropped quite a bombshell.
Too right. I mean, I had no idea that Dor was pregnant. I didn't think, you know, like... Well, I mean, we only... Well, you know, once.
I can see you're very fond of your wife, young man. And you'll love the baby just as much when it comes. It would be a crime for Doreen to have an abortion.
Oh, she won't, you know. There's no way we're going to get rid of it.
That's the spirit. And I want you to make your feelings clear to your wife, young man.
Oh, well, I mean, she only said that because I said I didn't want to have a family just yet. Look, do you think I could see her now?
Of course. If you wait in the garden, I'll send her out directly.
Can't wait to see her. Geez, a baby, eh? I can't believe it.
Slow down, will you, Brabham?
I've got to keep fit now that I know Jase is going to be all right. You know what I'm going to do when I get out of here?
Hit the bottle.
God, no. I'm going to buy Josie a bike so she can ride to school. I bet she's never done that before, poor little pet. Not with her gammy leg. Her and me, we're going to do all sorts of things when I get out of here.
What? You two are going to go bike riding together? I don't ride penny farthings anymore, you know.
Oh, God, I hope not. But she'll look sweet as she works her beat on a bicycle bill for two.
Geez, I wish something good had happened to me for a change.
Don't worry, love. As soon as you've had that abortion, everything will change.
Yeah, but I mightn't get it. Not the way Agnes feels about it.
It's got nothing to do with her. She can't stop you.
Yeah, but you mightn't do anything about it until it's too late.
Listen, that old bag hasn't organised something by tomorrow. You go straight to the governor.
Maybe I ought to tell Kevin.
Look, love, we've been through this before. Okay, he might stand by you, but you can't bank on it. It's best if you look after this yourself.
Yeah, I suppose so.
And for God's sake, stop looking like it's the end of the world, will you?
Doreen, you've got a visitor.
Well, who is it, Mrs. Jackson?
Your husband. Well, what's wrong?
Well, I had a visit from him yesterday.
Well, that's all right. Miss Forster arranged it.
Ah, she got off her bum at last.
Don't tell me Forster did something useful for a change.
That's enough, Smith. Come along, Doreen.
Go on, love. You stick to our plan. Nothing can go wrong.
All right, Butchie, don't be impatient.
Miss Forster?
Oh, Mrs. Davidson, won't be a moment. Come in, dear. What do we owe the pleasure of this visit?
It's about Doreen Burns. I see you've allowed her a second visit this week. Is there any special reason for this?
Oh, yes, dear. Poor little Doreen is pregnant. And you know what? The silly girl wanted to have an abortion. So I brought Kevin in to persuade her against such an evil act.
Oh, I see.
Well, that's what I'm here for, surely. Would you care for some tea?
No, thank you. I have a great deal of work to do, as I'm sure you have.
Oh, no, I'm not too pushed at the moment now that I've solved Doreen's little problem.
What about the other women? Now that the factory project has been abandoned, we need to look at other rehabilitation programs. I thought you might have some ideas.
Oh, no, I've been far too busy settling in here, but I'm sure something will come to mind.
Well, the need for alternative projects is rather urgent.
Yes, yes, I understand. Now, is there anything else?
I believe you've seen Kay White.
Oh, yes, poor girl, a dreadful affliction. Compulsive gambling.
We'll be discussing Kay at our next classification meeting, so if you have any ideas, perhaps you could jot them down and we could go over them then.
Good. I'm sure I'll be quite useful there.
Well, I'll be expecting you in my office at 5:30 tomorrow with the other staff.
I'll be there. Oh, Butchie, he just loves that tin food.
Hello.
Hi.
Well?
Well, what?
Well, haven't you got something to tell me?
What do you mean? I thought I told you everything yesterday.
No, you didn't tell me about the baby, Doreen.
How do you know about that?
I thought women were supposed to tell their husbands first. But no, you have to go blabbing off to the social worker.
Well, she shouldn't have told you, the rotten old bitch.
Yeah, well, why didn't you tell me, Dore?
Well, I tried to tell you yesterday.
When I first heard about it, you know, I was excited. I mean, I was going to be a father. I started thinking about the future, what I was going to do with the business. I mean, it'll all be his one day, and then Miss Forster tells me that you want to get rid of it. Why?
Well, you said you didn't want to start a family.
No, I said I didn't want to plan a family, you know, but, well, now that's happened, it's terrific.
No, Kevin, I'm not having it.
But, Dore, I said it's all right. Why?
Mrs. Jackson, can I go in now?
Hey, no. Now, Dore, we've got to talk about this. I mean, it's my kid too, you know.
No, Kevin, it isn't.
Yeah, well, I don't suppose one more surprise is going to hurt me. So whose is it then?
Can't we just forget about it?
No, we can't. I'm supposed to be your husband, or maybe you forgot about that. I suppose anything in pants would do.
Kevin!
Yeah, that's right. I'm a slut. I'll screw around with anybody. That's what you think, don't you?
Yeah, well, what am I supposed to think if it's not my kid?
I was raped.
Who?
Doreen. We've got to know.
I suppose all the girls in here are fair game. First it's Blim and Stewart and now this.
Oh, no, it wasn't anybody in here. It was Vince Talbot.
What do you mean? Who's Talbot?
He worked at the factory. Why didn't you tell somebody then?
Well, you're going to tell somebody now, because we're going to go to the police.
No, Kevin,
no,
I
Doreen,
can't.
We're going, you know? I know you don't think it'll do any good, but it will. Like, rape's a crime. I reckon this is the first time you're going to get a chance to show that somebody's done the wrong thing by you. Well, that's only fair, isn't it?
I think she's had enough, Kevin.
All she's been through. Well, I'm going to see Mrs. Davidson, then I'm going straight to the police. I'm only doing it because I love you.
And it's fearless like coming to the turn around the bend in front. Brutus coming to within a half length, and then there's a long gap to the rest into the straight now. And Brutus driving hard on the outside
come
after
on,
fearless light. It's Brutus on the outside
come
going
on,
a shade
Brutus.
The better. And Brutus got up to win by a head fearless light in
good
second place.
Boy.
Jackie.
Pity you didn't back him.
You again.
Book's up now if you're interested.
Huh?
Thought you'd jump at the chance. Oh, that's right. B cleaned you out, didn't she? Shame. Sherry's blessing in the third sounds like a good thing.
She's only running at 7-1.
I make the odds around here.
It just as a matter of interest. What are you offering?
Oh, 10-1. Could go 13s. Still, if you're broke, I suppose knowing how good the odds are, it only upsets you. Hey, easy.
All right. $5 on Sherry's blessing at 13-1.
I thought you were broke. Where did that come from?
Oh, I've been saving it for a rainy day. Well, you're not backing down, are you? Funny. I never thought of you as a piker.
Now, they're moving into the line for the third event at Tyneton.
Where is she? She's been out for half an hour.
Oh, she'll be all right. Don't worry.
As long as she doesn't spill the beans about the baby.
She wouldn't do that. Kev's a nice young bloke, but don't think he'd take to that.
You know, in a way, it's a lucky thing he doesn't want to start a family so soon. Otherwise, poor Doreen would have to live with a lie for the rest of her life. What's wrong, love?
She told him. She told him about the kid.
Who?
That Forster bitch.
Oh, she had no right.
I told you she was against abortion. She got Kevin in to make him talk me out of it.
Stupid bitch. The only time she ever gets off her backside, she goes and causes trouble. What did Kevin say?
Well, I had to tell him, Bea. I couldn't lie to him. Not about something as important as a kid. I had to tell him that it wasn't his and everything.
Oh, God. What did he say to that?
Well, he reckons I've got a charge, Talbot. He's going down to the police now.
Good on him.
But I don't want to.
Listen here, dimwit. You got the abortion now for sure. And charging that Talbot bastard's the best thing you could ever do.
Come in.
Mrs. Davidson, Kevin Burns would like to speak to you.
Oh, yes, bring him in.
Kevin?
Hello, Kevin. Miss Forster's just told me you're going to be a father. Congratulations.
Oh, Mrs. Davidson,
that's... It's not mine, is it?
I beg your pardon?
It's not my bloody kid, is it? You were once sent out in a bloody work program.
Come on, Kevin, this isn't going to get you anywhere.
Look, I'm sorry, Mrs. Davidson. I just don't know what to do.
Well, for heaven's sake, what's this all about?
Doreen has just told Kevin that the baby isn't his.
She was right, Mrs. Davidson.
Mrs. Jackson, will you please tell me what's happened?
Doreen has just told Kevin that Vince Talbot raped her at the factory.
But that's appalling. I'll get Doreen in at once so that we can get all the facts.
Yeah, well, I've got all the facts on it. I'm going straight to the police.
It's up to Doreen to make the charge.
Well, she won't do it. She's so frightened she just wants to forget about it. Then I'm going to make sure he gets what's coming to him.
Have you discussed the abortion?
Oh, no. Look, I don't know. I don't know what to think.
Well, perhaps you can discuss it with Doreen later when you're a little calmer.
Calmer? When I know what that bloke did to her, I want to kill him.
I hope you're not going to be so foolish as to take the law into your own hands.
Oh, no. I'm going down to the police station now and I'll get things moving down there. Look, I'm sorry, Mrs. Davidson. I just need to let off some steam. I feel, you know...
I wish I could do more, but... Don't worry about Doreen. She'll be well looked after.
Yeah, OK. Thanks. I'll see you later.
Goodbye, Kevin, and please try not to worry. We're all working together now. Dreadful thing to have happened. What I can't understand is why nobody reported it. The women must have known.
When do they tell us anything? Besides, they probably wanted to deal with Talbot themselves.
Yes, that's obviously the reason for the attack the other day.
I wish I'd known. I'd have been tempted to let them get on with it.
Yes.
What's going to happen with Doreen?
Once Kevin has made the report, I imagine the police will want to question her. In the meantime, she'll have to be watched very carefully.
Was there something else?
No, well, it's just that I feel so personally responsible for what happened, Meg. I was so keen for the factory project to go ahead, I allowed the women to be manipulated. Financially, by Andrew Reynolds, and now this with Talbot.
That man would see any woman as fair game. Which we are, if someone wants to take advantage of us. I mean, look what Jeff Butler did to me.
And what Andrew Reynolds did with me. We're both victims, Meg. Just like Doreen.
Oh, good morning, Miss White.
Good morning, Mr. Spencer. How's it all going?
Well, I've examined the police charges against you. 35 in all, and all well documented.
Which means I don't stand a chance.
Oh, I wouldn't give up hope yet. You have a very good chance. If we can prove to the court that you stole because of your compulsion to gamble.
Well, how do we do that?
Psychiatric evidence. After Dr. Weisman's initial assessment, he feels that you do have a genuine addiction to gambling, and so he is willing to assist you.
To help me to break the habit?
Precisely. But it is extremely important that you cooperate with him. Show him that you're sincere in your desire to be helped.
Well, don't you think I'm sincere?
Yes, I do. Naturally, refraining from gambling will be a start.
Well, I don't get too much of a chance in here, do I?
No, I suppose not. Whatever facilities Wentworth provides, the TAB isn't one of them.
Oh, it's a relief in some ways being in here. Gives me time to dry out.
Good. Well, what about when you're released?
When or if?
When? With Dr. Wiseman's testimony, there's a strong possibility that you will be acquitted. At the very worst, you should get a good behaviour bond.
Oh, here's me thinking I was spending the next 10 years in here. But now maybe...
You'll be a free woman? Well, I for one hope so. You have every chance now that you're determined to give up gambling.
Oh, I can't tell you how much I want to.
It's now that she needs her gram. Oh, I wish I could have a half day before she comes out of hospital.
Yeah, well, don't ask Agnes. She'll be waiting till Christmas.
Yeah, she won't do nothing. We ought to get up a demo. Give Forster the big A.
Wouldn't work.
No, but we got to do something. Especially since she blabbed on door.
It doesn't matter.
Yes, it does, and I'm never going to speak to her again.
That's not such a bad idea.
Oh, she wouldn't care. It'd just make her job easier for her.
But it'd make everyone else's job harder.
How do you mean?
Gather around. Listen, whenever you want leave or overnight passes or help with your families, anything the social worker should handle, go to Davo instead.
She'd just send us to Ag the Bag.
Of course she would. She might also get the message that we think Forster's weak as water.
Oh, that'd put a spanner in the works.
You got that?
Yeah.
Right. Good. Poor love. She's going to be on the pension sooner than she thought.
Doreen, the police are here to see you.
I have to.
Go on, love. Just make sure you lay out in that bastard Talbot.
Can I go to the loo first, Mrs. Jones?
All right. Come along.
Ah, I was wondering when you'd show up. Sherry's blessed one.
Big deal. So you picked one at last.
Okay. $70. And I'll count it.
I will. Just to make sure there's no mistake. It's 20, 30, 50, 70.
All right. So be a good girl and hand it over.
I owe you 70. You owe me 50. From the factory. Remember? Well, now you're flush, you can pay me back.
You bitch.
Oh, don't be like that. Don't spend it all at once.
Doreen, I'm Sergeant Hennessy. Do sit down.
Well, what are we doing in here?
This sort of thing is unpleasant enough, so we want to make you as comfortable as possible, especially in your condition.
Would you like a cup of tea, Doreen?
No, thanks, Mrs. Jackson.
Okay. Your husband told me what he knew, but I'll need to hear it from you. Can you tell me exactly what occurred? I'm sorry, Doreen, but I need facts. Now, just as briefly as possible.
Well, he took me to the storeroom and locked the door. I tried to get away, but he said he'd give me a bad time if I didn't, you know, do it with him.
Mm-hmm. Were there any witnesses?
No, we were locked in.
And afterwards?
I just wanted to forget about it.
I can sympathize with you, but if you'd told someone, you would have got help. The police force has doctors, social workers and so on, especially to help rape victims.
Yeah, well, I didn't know that.
It's a great pity. Are you sure there's nothing else you can tell me?
Look, try to think, Doreen. Anything.
We do want to bring Talbot to court if it's at all possible.
No, nothing else.
I'm sorry, Doreen. The lateness of complaint, lack of forensic evidence, witnesses, make it very difficult to prove that you were raped. I'm afraid there's just not enough evidence to charge Talbot.
It's okay. I understand. Can I go now?
Yes. I'm sorry, I can't do anything for you.
Hello. Miss Forster, isn't it?
That's right. And what could I do for you, young man?
Oh, I'm the department psychiatrist, Dr. Wiseman. I've come to see Kay White, you see, and
how do you know? And what good would that do the poor girl?
Well, A great deal, I should hope.
Fiddlesticks. You hedge shrinkers do more harm than good with your mumbo jumbo. What poor Miss White needs is a little self-control.
Well, it's a bit more difficult
than that. And I believe a psychiatrist are a waste of the department's money. If you're a doctor, you should be practicing real medicine.
Yes, I suppose I should.
Nothing could convince me otherwise. Now, please state your business.
Well, I was wondering if I could use your room again to see Kay White.
You most certainly may not. But she was most upset last time. Strangers prancing around the room.
Well, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to prance.
Apology accepted.
Well, it's been very nice meeting you. I'll see Kay White in the interview room. It's not as comfortable as Miss Forster's office, I'm afraid, but it'll have to do.
It's okay.
Sit down. Now, the last time you told me about your childhood, which seemed to indicate the root of the problem, now, could you tell me now exactly how you feel when you get this urge to gamble?
Well, it's like being torn in two. One half of me wants to resist, and the other half urges me on. Then it gets so bad, I can't resist anymore.
And how does it make you feel?
Oh, good to begin with. I've got what I wanted. Then I start thinking about it, and I feel bad. Bad, giving in. I feel like a kid, you know. Out of control, helpless.
You told me how badly you feel about yourself, that you're a failure. No one's going to have any respect for you. And yet, you committed crimes over a long period of time without showing any concern or remorse. My big problem is that I don't know if you really want to change.
What do I have to say to you? Perhaps I've been hedging. Perhaps I've been putting it too nicely. I am sick of the sight of myself. I hate what I'm doing. I mean, you just think about it, Doctor. Do you want to wake up every morning and hate what you are? I hate the way you behave? Because I do. I feel helpless. I can't do it by myself. I need help.
You will have.
You'll help me?
Yes, of course.
I'm sorry I'm late, Mrs. Davidson. I was just seeing Dr. Wiseman out.
It's quite all right, Mrs. Jackson. Miss Forster hasn't arrived yet.
Does it matter?
A reception. Would you ring Miss Forster and remind her that the classification meeting is about to start? Oh, I see. Thank you. It appears Miss Forster has left for the day.
Typical.
Did anyone think to tell her that the meeting was on?
Yes, I reminded her yesterday, but it could have slipped her mind.
Like everything else. Oh, we just can't continue, Mrs. Davidson. She simply isn't doing the work she's meant to be.
Well, she's only been here 5 minutes. Give her a chance to get used to the place.
The only thing she's getting used to is an easy job, like all social workers. All she ever does around here is make cups of tea and talk to that ridiculous cat.
Bennett. Now, that's true, Mrs. Davidson. There's vital work to be done here, and she isn't doing it. Now, what we need is a competent social worker, and quickly. Now, I don't like to say this, but I think Miss Forster should be retired.
Look, she's not that bad. I think that she could have quite a lot to offer once she settles in.
It's well known how you feel about little old ladies.
Miss Bennett, that is quite enough. We are not here to discuss Miss Forster's shortcomings. I suggest we do our job and get on with the classification meeting. Now, our most important problems are Kay White and Doreen Burns.
Hi. The girl said that you went to the cops about Talbot. What'd they say?
They said they can't lay a charge because there's not enough evidence. I need witnesses.
Damn that mongrel. I'll go witness for you, Dor.
What could you say?
Well, I could tell them that I saw you go into the storeroom with Talbot and then say that you told me what happened when you came out.
Thanks, Jude. But it wouldn't help.
You know something? It seems to me that maybe you're not interested in laying charges.
No, it's just that I'm worried about what Kevin's going to say when he finds out that nothing's going to happen.
It's you that got raped, Doreen. It's you that has to do something about it. It's got nothing to do with Kevin.
It has. He was the one who made me go to the police in the first place.
What do you mean, made you go?
It's okay. He's been great about it.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's easy for him, isn't it? He wasn't the one that got raped.
He was trying to help me.
He was trying to get revenge, you mean? Don't you understand, Doreen? It's his bloody ego that got hurt. Someone else screwed his wife. Of course he's got to take revenge.
Oh, I don't know. Maybe you're right.
Of course I am.
Yeah. But I've got to have something to hold on to. I love Kevin. He's the only thing that means anything to me anymore.
That's yours for a place.
Right. And that's about it.
Not quite. What about my win in the fifth?
Oh, yeah. $3.75.
What's so funny?
Nothing like the big plunge, is there? $3.75.
Face, Lizzie, or I might...
You're what? Thump a little old lady. Lizzie was just being sympathetic, weren't you, love?
On the outside, I bet you play for bigger stakes.
Of course, it makes it much easier when you can get your fingers into the petty cash.
Oh, yeah. Smart idea, that one.
Can't be too smart if you get caught. Still, you got to lose sometime.
Now, look, Lizzie.
Give it a break. You interested in the trots?
Of course she is. She's got $3.75 to spare.
Oh, now, come on, come on. Don't be tough on the girl. After all, she's trying to give it up. Aren't you, what?
You interested in the trots or not?
Sure. If you want the money, come to my cell.
She's cracking, B.
Yeah, I thought she was going to take a swing at you.
Well, why didn't you let her? I can take it.
Yeah. Right, all we have to do now is wait until she loses again, stir her, she'll do her block, and if there's a screw around, she'll end up in solitary.
Very, very thrilling affair. Numbers now coming into the frame. Very tight finish. Here they are now. In the garden first. In the garden first. Second, Golden Boy. And third, Sir Cindy.
Bugger it.
Not interested in the last race.
You know I haven't got any more money. That was my last cent.
No need to get upset. You've got to lose sometime.
And just what do you mean by that?
You're punchy, aren't you? I only said...
You said I was a loser. Well, what would you know?
Settle down. I only...
What is going on in here?
Nothing.
Get back to your cell. Well, White, what's wrong?
Nothing, Miss Bennett.
Well, it's pleasant to see another smiling face for a change.
And maybe you can give me something to smile about. I'm dropping dead. What's made you so happy? What Kevin did to Doreen, and what your friend Talbot did in the first place, bloody men. You just leave my things alone. You listen to me. Now, I didn't ask to share with you, and while we're stuck in here, we might as well make the most of it. And don't you ever speak to me like that again, you understand?
As bad as all that?
Oh, everything's just as bad as it was yesterday.
No,
it's... Any worse?
Not. Can't be. Well, Kevin knows, and he's going to take care of you.
He won't want me anymore. He'll reckon I'm dirty.
Oh, he's sticking by you now, isn't he?
Yeah, but Judy says that he's only doing it because of his own pride.
Oh, forget Judy. She wouldn't know anything about blokes, now would she?
No, I suppose not.
No. Don't you worry about Kevin. He'll stick by you.
Oh, but what am I going to do, Pete? Going to the police didn't do any good. And Kevin and me, we never even talked about what we're going to do about the baby.
Something's finally being done about that Forster woman.
Oh? What?
Mrs. Davidson's going to the department about it.
What I can't understand is why she was sent here in the first place.
Probably the department's idea of a joke.
Erica?
Oh, hello, Ted.
Hello, how nice to see you. Are you going up to see me?
Yes, I am.
Oh, good. How are things at Wentworth?
Not too good, I'm afraid. Huh? Agnes Forster's causing a few problems.
Oh, yes, so I believe. Dr. Weissman was in before. Apparently she gave him a bit of a hurry up yesterday.
It's really not very funny, Ted.
Well, I suppose not. It's just that I've had a long experience with Agnes. She seems to cause trouble wherever she goes.
You mean you knew she was incompetent and you still sent her to Wentworth?
Well, no, I wouldn't say incompetent. It's a rather serious charge.
Well, what would you call her? Certainly not a social worker. Because of her ineptitude, she's damaged the relationship between myself and my staff and alienated the women. She's turning the place into a shambles. Please, Ted, a replacement.
Oh, dear. They don't grow on trees, you know. Look, couldn't you put up with her till the end of the year?
Until she retires. Mm. Wentworth is a prison, not a rest home for departmental geriatrics.
Yes, all right, point taken. Well, look, I'll try to replace her, but I don't like her chances.
But you will.
I'll do my utmost, all right? Now, look, while you're here, there is another matter. Jim Fletcher has applied for governorship at Barnhurst, and he's noted you as referee. What do you think?
He's extremely capable and competent.
Mm. Governor material?
Well, he's shown a certain amount of concern for the women as people, individuals rather than just prisoners. I consider that important in a governor.
But you have reservations.
Oh, dear, how should I put this? If he sees something he approves of, he's for it. If not, his approach to the problem is emotional and personal rather than rational.
In other words, his lack of formal training in social work shows up, eh?
Well, yes, but I don't think that should rule him out of the job.
Well, would you give him a positive recommendation overall?
Oh, yes, he has a great deal to contribute to the prison service. I must make a move.
Yes, all right. Now, look, don't worry about that transference. I'll do what I can, all right?
Thank you, Ted. Goodbye.
Lovely seeing you. Bye-bye.
I've been thinking. I think it's about time we put our anti-ag program into action.
Beauty!
So, have any of you got any problems? How about you, Doreen?
Oh, I've got to talk to Kevin first.
Yeah, well, I've got a few things need sorting out.
Hey, come on, ladies. That's lunch, or don't you want any?
I've got something more important, Mr. Fletcher. I've got to see the governor.
Should have put your application in before breakfast, Lizzie.
It's urgent. It's about my little granddaughter. She's still in hospital, see? And I want to see her, so I've got to ask Mrs. Davidson.
Well, that's a job for the social worker.
Social worker? What social worker? I didn't know we had one.
All right, what's all this about?
Nothing. Just that my trial's coming up in a couple of days. I want to organize a lawyer. I'd like to see Mrs. Davidson after Lizzie.
If you need that sort of help, that's a job for Miss Forster. And you'll be seeing her, and so will Birdsworth.
Might as well be seeing her cat.
For your information, Smith, Miss Forster has had 40 years' experience with the department. Although she probably hasn't had to deal with a bunch of rat bags like you lot.
Oh, he does know how to hurt, doesn't he, girls? Now, I just wonder what Miss Forster's done to get into Fletcher's good books.
Oh, he just likes little old ladies, don't you, Lucy?
Oh, I'm sorry, Fletch. Come on, girls, lunch.
You want to see the social worker?
No way.
What about you, Brian?
Oh, no, I'm going to wait to see Mrs. Davidson.
Well, you'd be waiting.
What is it with you, Fletch? I wouldn't have thought you could care less whether we had a social worker or not.
You don't deserve one.
Oh, well, maybe if Mrs. Davidson realised that, we won't have one.
Ah, Miss Forster, let me do that.
Oh, thank you. Makes the room look so much homier, don't you think?
Yes. How's that?
Oh, that's fine. Mm-hmm. Fine, fine.
Good.
I'm so glad you turned up. I haven't seen a soul all morning. Would you care to join me for lunch?
No, I won't, thank you. Miss Forster, I...
Agnes, do sit down, dear.
Thank you. Agnes, I don't mean to worry you, but, well, there's been some rumblings.
What on earth do you mean?
Well, some of the women here, they've got it into their heads that you're, well...
Not Paul Reed.
Well, yes.
I never pretended to be. I'm a facility to be used. And if the women don't seek me out, well, it's their misfortune.
Yes, well, there's also the staff.
Oh, yes. Oh, dear, you are being coy.
Well, they're being pretty hostile. They're saying that you're not the right person for the job and so forth.
When you've been the public service as long as I have, you make enemies. I think I can deal with whatever Wentworth has to dish out.
Yes, but it could go further than that. What if it goes to the department?
Oh, dear. I'm a public servant. And if you're worried about me getting the sack, you can forget it. They never sack anyone.
Yes, but they could seek an early retirement.
Oh. Thanks for the warning, dear, but there's no need to worry about me. I'll be all right.
Yes, well, I hope so. Well, I'd better be getting about my duties.
Yes, dear. See you later. Oh, poor she. What are they trying to do to us? We don't do anyone any harm. And they push us from pillar to post. And now they want to retire us. Then what will we do?
Here's a posting.
Right. Brian.
Thanks very much.
Stokes. Nagel. White. Smith? Sorry, B.
Oh, well, how many letters do I get anyway?
Oh, Lizzie.
Yeah, Mrs. J.
Mrs. Huntley phoned an hour ago. She says there's some complications with the operation.
Oh, no, nothing serious.
No, don't get upset. It just means Joyce will be in hospital a little longer. Here, you can see for yourself.
Oh, I can't even get to see the poor little mite.
Come on, don't get getting yourself into a state, Lizzie. Ellen would have said if it was something serious.
Yeah.
Come on, let's keep your mind off it. We'll go and go have a couple of hands of poker.
All right.
Bastard.
Good news, eh? Boyfriend dump you or what?
Bloody Reynolds.
Your boss from the factory. Is he offering you your job back?
Oh, no way.
Dear Kay, I can hardly hope you are well under the circumstances, but if there's any assistance I can offer, don't hesitate to ask. Bloody hypocrite.
Well, that seems pretty good considering what you did to him.
He's the reason I'm in here. I offered to pay him back, but oh no, he's got to call in the police.
Well, it's better than a poke in the eye, isn't it? I'll tell you what. Why don't you write to him? Ask him to be a character witness at your trial. It's just a suggestion.
Who's yours from?
My aunt.
Good news?
What do you care for?
I don't. I was just being polite, seeing as you were so interested in mine.
Well, it's about my father's will, you see. He's left everything to me. The whole kit and caboodle.
How much?
$30,000.
What's there to cry about?
My sisters are contesting it.
Well, so long as the will's clear, they haven't got a leg to stand on. You're rich. Congratulations.
Yeah, terrific. Get out the champagne. Woo, 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 woo. Even if I get the money, I won't be able to spend it for 5 years.
Oh, look on the bright side. Think of how much interest it'll earn.
Get lost, will you?
Where do you think you're going, White?
The recreation room, if that's all right with you.
Here comes the bad loser. You want to know how to get her out of your hair?
Do I? What? She wins, she rubs it in. If she loses, she's ready to smash me. Who needs it?
Look who's crawled out of the woodwork.
Cut that out, Birdsworth.
Do you want another hand?
Yeah, it's your deal.
Okay. Anything good on?
See for yourself.
We could listen to the races. Three at Pakenham sounds a beaut. Still, if you'd rather watch the Three Stooges. It's good odds. But I suppose you're broke.
Lay off, Gaffney.
Lost it all, did you?
I said lay off, Gaffney.
Loser.
Don't you speak to me
Stop
like that,
you loser! That's enough, White! Get off her! You're coming with me.
To the governor's office, perhaps?
Did you hear that? They
said shut up.
Up.
Get moving!
Shut up!
Mrs. Jackson.
Oh, hello, Kevin. Any news?
Yes, you could say that. The cops have just told me they're not going to prosecute Talbot.
It's just a pity there wasn't more evidence.
Yeah, it was lack of evidence, was it? Yeah, well, I tried to find out what was going on, but they wouldn't say why.
Well, I...
Look, can I see Doreen, please? I mean, there may be something she's forgotten to say.
Oh, I'm sure she's told the police everything
no,
she could.
No, I should have been there. You know, she's probably so frightened she'd forget everything. Could I see her, please, just for a minute?
Well, I suppose it'd be all right. Why don't you wait here and I'll go and get her?
Thanks.
You all right? Sure. Just wanted to expect the Incredible Hulk, was I?
Yeah, sure about that. Still, it wasn't a good cause.
It better be. If White doesn't get put in a pound this time, I'll make sure she gets it my way.
Don't worry, you won't lift a finger. Vera saw what happened. She'll tell Davo. Hey, Jude, I reckon you'll have your cell to yourself for a while.
Suits me.
Doreen?
It's Kevin, isn't it?
That's right.
Go on, love. You get out there and you talk about having that abortion.
You know that kid's fallen to pieces? I don't think Kevin's going to be any help at all.
Yeah, well, maybe it doesn't look like it, but they've got to talk turkey sooner or later. And now Doreen can't lay that rape charge. Well, they've got to talk about the baby and their future.
That's right.
I still don't like it.
Yeah, well, nor do I. But they're the only ones who can sort it out.
White and Gaffney were talking quietly together when suddenly White threw Gaffney to the floor. If I hadn't been there, she could have killed her.
Thank you, Miss Bennet. White?
What Miss Bennet says is true.
At least you're not denying it. Do you have any excuse for your action?
No excuse, but I do have an explanation.
Then I would like to hear it.
I saw Dr. Wiseman yesterday, and he thinks he can help me with my problem. So rather than staying in my cell listening to the races, I thought I'd be much better off in the recreation room.
So you would not be reminded of the gambling?
Yes. I was sitting watching television when Margot Gaffney started taunting me about my habit.
And that's when you attacked her?
Yes, I played right into her hands.
What do you mean by that?
Oh, you must know the women don't like me. They've been needling me ever since I arrived. The best way to get at me is through the system. Provoke me into lashing out, and then they know I'll be put into solitary.
Which is no more than you deserve.
I know that. All I'm saying is I was set up.
Quite. But as long as you respond to their taunting, they will continue to provoke you.
Yes, I know.
And how do you propose to cope with that? Hit another inmate?
Well, now I know how they work, I think I can handle them.
Good. However, for your own safety, I would suggest that you spend as little time with the other women as possible.
You mean solitary?
No. I am prepared to give you another chance.
But she attacked Gaffney. She deserves
Thank you, Mrs. Davidson. I appreciate that chance.
I hope so. Take her to her cell, Miss Bennet.
Come on, come and sit down. You've got to look after yourself, you know. Now, look, Dor, I don't want to hassle you, but I've just been talking to the cops, and they say they're not going to lay any charges against Talbot. Why? I mean, there must have been something you could have told them.
There wasn't enough evidence.
That's right, Kevin. It would be practically impossible to press charges.
Well, okay. All right, so there isn't enough evidence. Well, I'm going to give Talbot something to go on with.
What do you mean?
Look, I'm going down to the factory just to let him know that I know, you know? Even if they can't press charges, I'm going to make sure his name's Dirt.
Don't, Kevin, please.
Why, don't you want to see him get what's coming to him?
Well, can't we just drop it? We can't do anything now.
No, Dora, unless you can give me a good reason, I'm going down to the factory.
Well, there is a good reason. Well, you know, I said that I was raped. Well, I was the first time.
The first time?
It happened again.
Do you mean to say he raped you twice? Why didn't you tell the cops?
Because he'd say that he didn't have to force me the second time. See, the second time, I let him do it.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare of waking up alone. On the inside, the roses grow, they don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are prisoners too. When morning comes around.